What's up, sports design family? Mike with Sports Templates back at it again today, and I'm going to show you how to take this Photoshop soccer kit mockup and turn it into this awesome Germany kit design in 8K resolution. So let's get started. Make sure you smash that subscribe button so you can catch all of our future tutorials. So before we dive into the template, let me show you a couple things that you're going to get when you purchase this template. So you're going to get this view that you see here, the front view, and you're also going to get the back view in a separate PSD document. So you can do the front and the back of the kit however you'd like to. So we're also going to have down in the comments a link to this library that has all the colors and design elements you're going to need to recreate this image. We're going to get as close as we can, go through things a little quickly so we don't take too much of your time, and show you how easy it is to do these kind of designs with this template. So let's get started. I'm going to first go down into the background. So everything's organized in these folders here. We're going to go down into the background folder, and I'm just going to change the color, and I've got a color here called background color in the library for you. Just something that's it's almost like an off-white gray color, just to give a little bit of contrast to the text that's back there. And for the text background, we can change that to whatever we want. We're just going to change it to Germany soccer, or you could put football or whatever you like to put. And then we'll go ahead and collapse that folder just so it's not taking up too much of our space down here. And we'll get into editing the actual uniform. So if we go into the uniform editable parts folder, it's all broken down into the different parts of the kit. So you've got all of the different areas of the jersey and the shorts and the socks and even the shoes. So let's just go bottom up. We'll start at the shoes, and we've got a left and a right shoe. So we'll start with our right shoe, and that's the mannequin's right shoe, right? It also happens to be on the right because of the way the legs are here. So let's start just changing the colors of things. Okay, so our spikes color, I'm going to select both of those layers. I did that by hitting shift and then clicking from one to the other, holding shift. You can also hold control and click individual layers that you want to. So maybe we want to do the laces at the same time. We're going to make all of those black. The base color, we're going to make this white, and you can't see it right now because it's hidden by the shoe design. And I'm actually going to keep that off. I'll show you why in a moment. Inner part colors, let's make those, I want to say this one is red and this one is yellow. And these are colors, by the way, from the German flag, which is also in the folder, the library that we're going to put in the comments. So you'll be able to match all those colors exactly if you need to. So let's just look at our reference image real quick. And yeah, that looks like we got that about right. We just need to get a logo on the shoe. Now, there is a shoe design smart object here. But for this particular logo that we want to add to the shoe, it's a little bit easier to just add it directly here. So up in the library, we've got the logo. We're just going to drop it and just kind of position it where we'd like it. So about there looks good. Now, we don't want that swoosh tail sort of hanging off the back of the shoe. So if we right click on that layer and make it a clipping mask, it will only show on the shoe since it's clipped onto the shoe design smart object there. And let's see, do we need to get one on the other shoe? Let's do that. So let's go to our other shoe, our left shoe, and let's change those colors. So again, we'll do red here, yellow here. We'll do our laces, our sole, and our spikes all black. So I just held down control to select those. We'll make those black. The base color of the shoe is going to be this white. And again, we'll turn off the shoe design. And I'm selecting that layer so that when I drag my shape in, it goes directly above it. And then I'm just going to rotate to match the shoe. I'm going to put it in a position that I like. That looks pretty good there. And we don't need to do the clipping mask since it's on the entire surface of the shoe. And the shoe is covered. Okay, let's move on. I'm going to collapse those folders down, and let's go into the socks. Now, if we look at our reference image, we've got white socks with a four-stripe pattern up at the top. Okay, so let's try to recreate that. So let's turn off the designs and we'll just select all of the sock color options and we'll make them that same white. And then let's go ahead and turn the designs back on and we'll just start with the left one, doesn't really matter. We've got that pattern here in the folder, so we'll just drop it in and position it right up at the top. Turn off these other layers. Control or Command S to save, and I'm just going to check, and it looks good. So I'm going to close that, and I'll go to my right sock design and just do the same thing. Drop that in, position it. If I hold Alt and click this layer, it'll make it the only visible layer. That's another trick you can do if you, instead of hiding lots of layers at one time. We'll just close that. And there we have the sock design. Okay, now let's get into the shorts. With the shorts, we just have black shorts with our number 3 on the left leg and our German soccer logo on the right leg. And that's something you just find on Google. It's also here in the library. So let's go into the shorts folder and we'll go, let's do left leg first, going bottom up. We don't need a different knee band color. Let's make all the colors black and go into our shorts design and we need to position number 3 in there. And that went below those layers. So let's just save that. Okay, so we just need to move it a little bit to the right. And let's compare that to our reference image. It's pretty close, maybe just a little bit more to the right. Okay, that looks good. And now let's go into the right leg. And the same thing, let's make the color black. We can turn off all of these different knee band design smart objects. These are to put a design around the band of the shorts or the cuff, if you will. And we're not going to do that right now. We're just going to go in here and we're going to drop our logo in and let's just size that down and maybe place it right about there. Okay, and that looks great. I'm just going to leave that right where it is. Let's go ahead and collapse the shorts folder and move up to the torso folder. In the torso folder, we have the jersey design and the color, right? And so let's make the color white. And the design, so this is not going to be necessarily the numbers or the logo patch on the jersey because those are going to be in a different smart object we'll get to later up here in the embossed logo and graphics. Those have a 3D embossed effect like they're a separate element placed on top of the jersey. This is really, this jersey design smart object here is to do a almost like a print on the fabric, right? So if you wanted to do any kind of design that's sublimated onto the fabric, we're going to do that here. So like you see in our reference image, we've got some stripes that are happening on the front. So let's go ahead and get into there. And again, in the library, we've got some different elements. These are the sleeve ones. You can see here with the black and red thicker stripes on the bottom. This is the one for the front of the jersey. So just drop that in and position it. And I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to hold the shift key so that when I stretch this way, it only moves vertically, it doesn't stretch horizontally as well. And let's just check that out. Okay, so that looks pretty good compared to our reference image. I don't really think I need to change too much. I guess maybe move it up a little bit is about the only thing we can do that's a little bit different. And that was probably a little too high. Yep, so I'm just gonna nudge it down just a little bit more. And we're going to call that good. Close out some of these additional tabs I had up here just so they're not taking up too much space. And now let's get into our sleeves. So for the right sleeve, let's make the color our white. And let's get into our sleeve design and drop this into place. And we're just going to position it. And this one I'm going to hold Shift and Alt. at the same time. That way it stretches both sides horizontally. And I'm going to go all the way out to the edges. And then I'm going to turn off these others. And actually, let me put this down below the levels layer just in case we wanted to use that to adjust the colors a little bit. Okay, and it looks like I need to move that up a little bit because I'm going to make that band a yellow color. So if I go to my band design, I'm just going to change it to yellow. And now I just need to position this up a bit so that the red is showing. So again, I'm going to hold the shift key and just stretch this vertically a little bit. Or actually, not stretch it, but just sort of condense it. And so that's a little too high, you can see, right? So I'm just going to bring it back down just a little bit. I did not mean to. I was using control instead of shift, and that's why it started changing the perspective a little bit. I'm hitting control or command S to save these, and there we have it. It's placed. So we can close out of that layer, and let's get into our left sleeve. Again, we're going to make the band color yellow. Sleeve color is going to be white. Turn off the band design on this one. And let's get into our sleeve design. Again, drop this in. Put it up here. And let's just center it. And let's just put it right about there. Okay, just needs to come down just a little bit. Tiny bit more. Oh, and you know what? For this one, this is actually above the band color, and I'm going to just swap this out. This is one of the things you can do with a custom Photoshop template, is make it work for you and move things around if you need to. We want to get that yellow band above the red part, so it kind of sits on top of it. And now I can see I need to bring that up just a little bit more. And that's looking great. So there's our design. All right, so let's get out of the sleeves and get into the collar. I believe we just had a black collar. Yeah, we do. So in the collar folder, we can change the collar color to black. If we wanted to do custom designs, we can use these smart objects here, but we just want a solid black collar for this design, so we're just going to turn those off. And now we just need to get into the number on the front. So in the embossed logo and graphics folder, if we scroll down into this folder that says add your design here, you can do logos on the sleeves if you want to. Okay, we don't have any for this design. And here's where you can do the jersey design. So let's drop in our number 3, and we'll just kind of position it right in line with the placeholder number 7. We can turn the 7s off. And let's drop in our football logo again. And we're just going to size that down. We'll try to get it right about there. Turn off the placeholder logo. We're going to hit Control Command S. I'm also going to close out a couple of these other layers. And there we have pretty good placement, right? We've got the number 3 and we've got the German football logo. So I'm going to hit Control 0 to zoom this back to the whole view. And the only other thing left to do is set the color of our mannequin. And if we look at the reference image, it's kind of a silver color. So let's go to the mannequin folder, which is here. Scroll down. All these layers are just the lighting on the mannequin. And we'll go to mannequin color, and let's try the same background color. And that looks great. Kind of got that silver look to it. So that's how easy it is to get one of these kits put together using this awesome Photoshop template from Sports Templates. Let's take a look if you zoom in at some of the details, right? So you can kind of see all the different things we've been talking about here. So you can see when you zoom in, you can see all the texture of the fabric. You can even see texture on the mannequin. There's kind of like scratches and things. You know, that's very common on like a plastic mannequin, so that looks really cool. You can see the texture of the fabric on the socks and the shoes. They kind of have this almost like a diamond pattern on the shoes, right? Show you this here. You can see the seams, right? The stitches on the shoes and the texture of the shoelaces. There's just so much going on there. You can see the pads, right? The shin guards underneath the socks. You can see the stitches on the shorts as well. You can see all the lighting coming in from everywhere that really gives this thing the depth that you want to see. And here on the jersey, right, where we did the embossed number, you can see all the texture, almost like a tackle twill texture. You can see some shadows there to give it depth, so it looks, you know, looks like it's really placed on top of the jersey. You can see all the texture on the cuffs, the sleeves, on the collar. All that realistic texture, all the, again, you can see the scratches and everything on the mannequin. It's 8K resolution, so you can see, you know, how realistic it really looks. So I'm going to hit Control or Command 0 to zoom back out, and there we have our finished product. So the last thing I want to show you is the dynamic lighting feature that comes with the Sports Templates offerings. So you can see I just turned it on and the lighting changed a little bit, and it's a smart object. So if you go in there, you can adjust the lighting. If you want to maybe change the lighting angles on your scene, or just, you know, have the light look a little bit different, you can come in to the smart object, click on the hue saturation layer, go to the properties, and you can just start dragging things around. Right, maybe you want the light to come in from the right like that. You can hit Control Command S and go back out. And now you can see we've got much more dramatic lighting coming from the right. So maybe you're putting this in like an outdoor scene and there's some light coming from that side. You can see what that looks like. So make sure you head over to sportstemplates.net, pick this soccer kit template up. We'd love to see what you create with it, so make sure you tag us on Instagram and Twitter, anywhere that you post these. TikTok even is a great one. And remember to hit that subscribe button, and we want to make sure that you see all of our future videos and learn as much as you can while we're showing you these awesome new templates. Thanks so much, guys, for your time. We will see you on the next one.